The Berkshire Eagle has a long and storied history, and now, after a little more than a year under vigorous new local ownership, they're about to roll out a major new feature. Eagle editor Kevin Moran and features editor Lindsey Hollenbaugh came in to tell us about that and a lot more that's going on at the Eagle.
A little bit more than a year ago, some local owners stepped forward, Berkshire-based owners, and with the goal of buying the newspaper and returning it to local ownership. And in that past year, the mission really has become to really get the Berkshire Eagle and our sister newspapers in Vermont back to the status of being among, if not the best local newspaper in the United States. And to that end, it's been a really busy year. We've had to, after being owned corporately for about 21 years, really had to plug in to our own systems. We had to bring in some staff to sort of, you know, even run our circulation departments. We've upstaffed in the newsroom. We've done a lot of things to get us to a standalone point. And now is the time when we can pivot, and we've already made some pivots in terms of proving the Berkshire Eagle, but we can really now focus on sort of that ground level good journalism that we want to bring to our readers.
There's so many things that have gone on in the past year that we do want to talk about in our short time together, but I want to focus in on a big thing that's ramping up, rolling out in the Sunday, May 28th, Memorial Day weekend, when everybody's got a little extra time, sit down, read the paper, relax with it. And Lindsey Hollenbaugh, I gather you're deeply involved in this.
Yeah.
It's something new that'll be in the Sunday Berkshire Eagle, and it's called Berkshire Landscapes. Give us a quick idea of what that's going to be about.
Certainly. So we're really, really excited about this new section that we're rolling out, like you said, Sunday, May 28th. We were tasked when the new owners came in, not only to become the best local newspaper in the country, but to have the best local arts and entertainment coverage in the country. As you know, the Berkshires is rich in so many cultural institutions, large places like Tanglewood, Barrington Stage Company, the Clark, Massmoca. And we've always done a stellar job of covering those. But we were tasked recently, probably about in January, I'd say, to reimagine and refocus our coverage. And we were given the tools and the time to really look at how we do it. And what we came away with was not just to look at how we're doing things, but to redo it completely. So we threw out our Sunday e-section, our lifestyle section, and we've created what we call landscapes, which will cover the many landscapes that make the Berkshires what they are. So that includes not just the arts and entertainment, but includes culinary landscapes, literary landscapes, the people, really. And so what this means is that we now have, at a minimum, a 12-page, all-local, all-color section that's going to cover the many landscapes that make the Berkshires so special. And every week, we're going to ask ourselves, what makes the Berkshires special? And let's cover that and give that to our readers.
Kevin Moran, I don't know if you know the average person out there understands, but for a newspaper to do a 12-page, all-local, all-color section, and to have had about 5 months or so to plan it and put it together and all the people needed to be in place, wow, that's a big deal.
Essentially, this is a newspaper unto itself every Sunday. So, and I will be so bold as to say that at least the first couple issues, maybe 16 pages plus. For the first issue, obviously, it's a big weekend in the Berkshires. Memorial Day weekend is absolutely a smashingly busy time. The Massachusetts Museum of Contemporary Arts is also has a big weekend, too, and so we'll be devoting a lot of coverage to that. But we've also got a lot of fun features that are going in that very issue as well. But you're exactly right. Where other newspapers nationally may be retrenching, this is a bold initiative to grow the paper and hopefully our readership and march on from there. I think the whole concept of what our local newspaper owners want us to do is to grow the newspaper by making some smart investments. And I think that Berkshire Landscapes is a very smart investment at this particular point. I mean, the Berkshires, just a couple weeks ago, was named one of the most vibrant medium-sized communities for arts. So we just seem to be hitting it, that nail right on the head.
it's a varied audience that you must serve, and they're looking for something special.
Yeah, and that's one of the things that we've really focused on in landscapes. And we're really, one of the things that speaks specifically to that is we were able to move our deadline for this new Sunday section to go live Saturday night. Currently, right now, our Sunday section goes Wednesday night to press. That's a huge difference for those at home who don't do this kind of thing. What this means is that we can get our Tanglewood music reviews from Andy Pincus into the Sunday section before the folks who maybe are weekenders leave for the weekend on Monday. We used to put those in on Monday because that's the only time we could get them in. We'll also get more theater reviews in by Jeffrey Borak. So we're really going to be able to target that weekend audience. And we're also really looking to those people who come from outside the Berkshires who are experts in their fields, and we're asking them to do guest columns for us. So, for example, in our first issue in the Culinary Landscapes page, we have Jim Nijame from Spirited Wines, who's going to write about how do you walk into a wine store and buy wine for a dinner party if you don't know anything about wine. So we're really leaning on this great population we have in the Berkshires in a way that we've never done before.
In general, these are seen as tough times for print media, time of retrenchment rather than growth. You guys are totally the opposite. If I remember my numbers right, 53 new employees at the Eagle in the last year, 30 in newly created positions. That's amazing. That's a real commitment from your ownership to make you a great community newspaper.
We are certainly have the opportunity and are changing the narrative about the direction of what a newspaper can take. And that's been exciting. It's been a heck of a lot of work. Mm-hmm. The work has been a lot of fun. But we are definitely working in a new direction. And we're doing it in a smart way. This is well planned out. This is not willy-nilly. I do not think this is a house of cards. We're building a foundation for the future, quite honestly. And we're rolling out fun things like Berkshire Landscapes. We have a bi-monthly magazine that I think in a few months is going to start going monthly called Upcountry. We've redesigned our newspapers. We've redesigned our websites. We're going to be looking at our business and sports sections in the Berkshire Eagle and reimagining those. Because really, the people of the Berkshires and beyond, and people who have connections to the Berkshires, really deserve this kind of reflection of their community in the pages of the Berkshire Eagle.
Well, Kevin Moran, Lindsey Hollenbaugh from the Berkshire Eagle, thanks for coming in. All the best with all the new features.
Thank you.